We did a study, and it was an international study 2 years ago. And we were wondering about not only the correlation, how do pathologists correlate international the scoring of PD-L1 different antibodies of PD-L1, but also we were trying just to correlate or try to correlate the expression of PD-L1 with different antibodies to the prognosis of the patient. So we did a very, it was a very kind of through very tedious work. It was based on TNMs of 640 tumors, all of them with diagnosis and a study properly. But we selected 648 tumors, and we did TMAs in all of them. And all of them, they were staying with the four antibodies of PD-L1, 22.3C, 28.8, CD6263, and the last one was SP142. So we did the staining, and we were seven pathologists from different countries who studied digitally all these tumors. So the staining was performed in Japan. In fact, I don't remember exactly the numbers, but the main TMAs, they were performed in Karolinska in Sweden. There was one pathology there. But we had other different types of TMA that were kind of roles. It was more difficult to study them. And they were performing in Japan. We have another pathologist. We have another pathologist in the States, in Rochester Mayo Clinic. One, it was myself here in UK. And there were two more pathologies studying. So at the end, what we did, we studied the correlation of scoring all of them. The results, the correlation was absolutely very good in all the antibodies that correlates also with other studies. We also saw that the staining of the tumoral cells with 142 was not ideal. It was very good for inflammatory cells. We saw some prognostic results with PD-L1, with PD-1, because not only we studied PD-L1, but also PD-1. It was correlate also with the staining in the inflammatory cells and PD-L1 with the grade of the tumor and stage D4. Yeah, it was a very, very tedious study, but I think it was quite interesting. And we also support the results of other studies and other journals.